Hello students, welcome to the class. In this class I will be dealing with the lead editorial, and like yesterday also I had dealt with the editorial related to data protection, privacy, and how India will be complying its data protection law with the new law development that has unfolded in European Union. In this very class I will be discussing about Cambridge Analytica data protection issue of the Facebook. What exactly was that and how the data is actually intruded? So we'll be understanding in this class two things about Cambridge Analytica, and then we'll be understanding the placing of servers. Primarily we'll be digging deep into this aspect. We'll be digging deep with respect to India. Like in India we generate a lot of data. We keep on logging in the websites like Instagram, then is Twitter, then is Facebook, and numerous other Tumblr, then is other websites like our applications, NewsBI, ASBuzz, etc., etc. We keep on actually logging in these websites and keep on providing our data. Now, where this data is stored? Now, like we have the industry kind of density, the more industry density is in the northern countries like in America, in European Union, and obviously in China, and the southern countries they're actually deficit in industry. But when we had undergone the service sector revolution, we had believed that there might be a kind of equity with respect to that, ki gareeb desh bhi service sector mein acha kar payenge. क्योंकि उनके पास बहुत ज़्यादा कुछ चाहिए नहीं है सर्विस सेक्टर में. वी डोंट नीड लॉट ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट इन दिस सर्विस सेक्टर एंड ऑलरेडी वी हैड द स्किल बिकॉज इंडिया इज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग मोर विद रिस्पेक्ट टू इट्स ओन GDP इन टर्म्स ऑफ सर्विस सेक्टर. बट एज फार एज दिस हाउ डू दिस सॉफ्टवेयर थिंग वर्क, हाउ डू दीज वेबसाइट्स वर्क, वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट इन अ बेटर वे. इट विल बी अंडरस्टैंडिंग द प्लेसमेंट ऑफ द सर्वर्स इन द वर्ल्ड. Now, like the data you are using for the Facebook or for the Instagram or for anything, the most of the data that you are actually giving to these websites, where is this data stored? Now, where is very important? Where is the most important component to understand the security about this entire domain data protection? Now, your data that you're providing to these websites, it is actually stored in the servers. Now, where are these servers? Now, like I've told you, there is a lot of asymmetry with respect to the placement of the servers. Now, because a lot of data has to be stored, and these servers, they require lot of, they require a facility whereby we can actually cool these servers. So that is the reason that most of the servers, that like 80% of the world servers, they are in the countries having cold climate or cool temperature is there. Like you can take the example of Scandinavian countries or Canada or United States of America. Now these are the countries in which maximum of the servers are placed. So the data that you are generating by logging into these websites, your data, most of the data is stored in the countries that are having the cool temperature, because it is not economical to place these servers in countries like India, because the temperature is actually high and it will take a lot of energy to actually cool these servers in order to make them workable for a longer period of time. So when it comes to the servers, because these servers are placed in the foreign countries, they are not in the territorial limit of India, so in order to handle how, in order to actually regulate how this data is protected, how this data is managed, we actually need a global legislation. we actually need a global standard, because without global standard it will not be possible and it will not be easy for countries like India to actually protect their data. So this is about the server thing. 80% of the servers are placed there. So a country like India, it should actually work on the technology of the servers, thereby we must actually impinge on the countries, we impinge on the companies to place their servers in the respective countries so that these servers can be regulated as per the law of the specific country. Now this is very important. Specific country. Now if we will not be able to do this thing, the scandals like Cambridge Analytica, they might keep on unfolding time and again. So we need a global legislation that can address the issue of the servers. Now this is one issue. Now another very important issue is democratizing how this internet corporation or this internet world actually works. Now there is one body called as ICANN. Now what does this ICANN actually stand for? Internet Corporation for Assigned Names and Numbers. And it is sometimes you will also find that it is an international corporation for assigned and names and numbers. Now it is this very organization that actually controls this www of the websites. So this is the body that actually controls the root of all the websites. Till last year, this organization wasn't working in a democratic manner. It was totally under the control of United States of America. But of late, this ICANN has been democratized. But again, there is a partial democratization of ICANN. So countries like India, they need that this ICANN should be democratized completely so that we can have the transparency, accountability of how the data is managed by the international software corporations. So we need to work on two things. One is the server and democratization. How do these websites work? This will make our life easy for regulating these things. Without proper regulation, we will be actually endangering the privacy of the people. We will be endangering how the elections, how the free and fair elections are conducted in countries throughout the world. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brain AIS. And for more information, you can read the information that is scrolling down. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.